Additional assignment received. Initializing.
They're beautiful, aren't they? I've seen all there is to see in this world, and yet, every time I return here, They steal my breath away. Listen. Their song. It's also beautiful. It has kept this city of the Arden concealed since the monstrous reign of Akhenaten. The song of the Sentinels has kept him silenced, chained inside his tomb, inside the Black Pyramid. It was naive of me to think it would be enough, that it would last forever. The disciples of the Arden have returned, as you well know. Akhenaten stirs in his sarcophagus. The Arden himself is awakening. This is why I have returned. Perhaps for the last time. It's also why you have come, though you may not know it yet. No matter how far I travel, how long I'm away, I always return to my duty. To my children. We have sat vigil in this temple of nightmares for 3,000 years. It may soon be at an end one way or another. The vigil is over, and we fight. It's no longer enough to conceal this place. It must be destroyed. Each of their aspects, each of their spirits and the gods they represent will be needed. And you must help us unite them all. Only then can the Black Pharaoh be defeated. Only then can we prevent the return of the Arden itself. And only then may my children finally be free of this place, of this world.
Good job. You really nailed this one. Keep this up and there's a place on the winning team when the dust clears.
I have failed. I have failed them, and I have failed you. This terrible city was supposed to remain hidden for all time. But perhaps it was inevitable. Secrets cannot be kept forever. And at least the Sentinels, my children, no longer stand alone. This is where the Black Pharaoh descended, step by bloodstained step, where his subjects were brought as slaves and sacrificed to his cruel god, Arden. It is a city born in blood, and there is nothing to be learned from its horrors. Arden is no god, and the Artenist religion knows nothing of true sacrifice. Made willingly, hearts filled with light and devotion, this thing called Arden only takes, demands, and devours men's innocence, their minds and souls, and nothing will still its hunger. We watched it once as it brought Egypt to her knees. And then we sacrificed ourselves and others to stop it. The world is bigger now. Given a chance, the Arden will spread his darkness beyond Egypt. Already the bloodshed increases and the carrion eaters gather around his altars. And my brave children cry out, afraid their strength won't be enough this time. I will not allow myself to believe they can fail. Because, should they fail? Then the next sacrifice of blood will be our future and yours. go with the moon.
Mine is the sad song. I guess it always was. You are all my father said you would be, and yet nothing like I imagined. It's hard to base a perception on a word, and it's wrong to chain someone to one place for all eternity. I see you here now, and it fills me with relief and horror, joy and sadness. Relief that this, the longest wait, is almost over. Horror you can see all around you. The voice from the deep is drowning my song in its noise as the catacombs fill with the slaves of darkness. Joy that my personal nightmare is perhaps coming to an end.
You're not leaving me, are you, big sister?
I will never leave you, my love. Never.
Promise?
I swear on my own children, little brother. I swear on all the stars in the sky, on all the grains of sand in the desert.
Okay, then.
And sadness for my little brother. He never knew anything but this half-life. And now even that is being stolen away from him. We are all that he has. If it weren't for him, I would just let go. I would let the deep voices in and allow them to still my song. I would rest. I would sleep. But I would miss him too much.
This is my daughter, Mutamoya. She holds the veil that kept the city hidden from the outside.
Hello, Father.
She embodies the spirit of Merit Sega.
Can you hear them whispering from beneath?
The tombs are stirring and the dead are waking. My song is fading. The voices from beyond are getting louder.
I know you are tired, my sweet, but you must channel your spirit.
In the filthy shadow of the Black Pharaoh's pyramid, his army is made strong. Their general has received all the blessings of the Aten.
Hack him to pieces. He will only laugh and spit black tar in your face.
Their god is a false one, but this is the cradle of its power.
My god remains true, but it has been so long. I do not know if he still holds court.
Don't let your sorrow invite blasphemy, brother.
You know that we outlived our civilization. What if we outlived our gods, too?
Then they live on through our pesajet. And through our memory, they are justified.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but... you're right.
Humility looks peculiar on you, sister.
Wanderer. When we rode out to face the Artanists, we wore divine sigils draped upon us by the boy King Tut himself. If you were to fashion the Eye of Horus, offer it upon an altar, I will endeavor to lend you that power. Wield it to cleanse the general's followers with your righteous fire. Then dispatch him.
So justice will be done.
So vengeance will be delivered.
So Egypt will be protected.
Quick access inventory updated.